Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, hi, my name is Katie. I live in Orlando and I make all home decor videos, shop with me videos, interior design. I love to give tips, shop fall and Christmas and holiday seasonal decor. So if you love home decor shopping videos, seeing what's new at your favorite store so you can know what to look for the next time you go, please make sure you give this video a big thumbs up, hit the subscribe button down below, and you can go ahead and hit the notification bell if you don't want to miss any of my new videos. If you are new here, you'll be so excited to know that every Tuesday on my channel we shop at Target, which makes it Target Tuesday. Definitely my favorite video of the week, always your guys' favorite as well. Everybody around here, we just seem to have this like mutual obsession with Target, and I am here for it. Just wait until someday maybe you could have like a reusable bag that you could use to support Target Tuesday, or maybe like a water bottle or a koozie, or maybe even like a sweatshirt. I don't know, guys, maybe that's coming, I don't know. But yes, today is Target Tuesday, so we're gonna be shopping all around the store. We're gonna take a kind of quick-ish look at the back to school stuff. Majority did rule in the last video. I had you guys let me know if you wanted to see it, and most wanted to see it. So because of that, I'm going to go ahead and show it, but it's not gonna be the whole center of this video. So if that's not your thing, don't worry, there are plenty of other things to see in this video. We're definitely gonna be checking out the dollar spot, seeing if there's any new items there that we haven't seen yet. The back to school stuff, college dorm stuff. We're gonna check out some clothes. We're just gonna kind of make our way around the store, and I will show you anything that is new, cute, something you might like. We're just gonna have, you know, a fun little casual Target Tuesday, see what's new, and we're just gonna have a great time. So if you're interested in seeing what is new at Target, just keep watching, because we're gonna head in right now. I'm seeing some cool new stuff in the dollar spot, so first I'm gonna show you everything that's new in the dollar spot right now. Oh, I'm getting this. My Instagram stories are about to have much better lighting. I'm sure Brian's gonna steal this from me. It's a 2-in-1 portable vlogging desk lamp. So you can use it as a lamp, but it also has a little phone holder. This is so cool. I don't think I've ever talked about this on here, but Brian actually has a YouTube channel. It's for this game that he plays called Rise of Kingdoms. So if you're looking for another channel to subscribe to, if you just wanna show your support, I'll link it down below. He's really close to being monetized and starting to make money on YouTube, which is so cool. I'm so proud of him. So I'll leave it down below if you guys wanna check it out. He's so cute, I love him. Sound out for all the mamas out there. Look at this portable sound machine. How cool. They have like waves, it says thunder and lightning, tree, forest, music. This is so cool. 4 relaxing sound options: ocean, rainforest, and white noise. This is amazing. Another really cool item, 3-in-1 charging cable. I could charge my computer while I charge my phone, which is really awesome. It is 3 feet in length and it is $5. Really cool new clear wall calendar. I haven't seen this one before. You could easily write on it with like dry erase and then just redo it every month. And this is $5. Also for $5, they have this clear to-do list. Really, really neat idea. You could put like a little hook on your fridge and put this on there. This is really, really cool. Few new dollar spot items I have not seen yet. Ultrasonic portable humidifier. This one looks like a little diamond, and then they have a green one that looks like a little flower. That's really, really cool. You can just stick it in a water bottle. This is $5. They have this collapsible water bottle I have not seen yet, also $5. They have some new yoga mats. So they have this pink one that says no bad days, no bad days. They've been doing a lot of stuff with that. They have this like charcoal color one that says do it with passion or not at all. And then they have this baby blue colored one that says do what you need to be okay. And these are all $5. Here is another size of the bento container that I showed in my last Target dollar spot video. This is perfect for like grapes, fruit, granolas, maybe even a parfait. It does say that it is leak proof, but it's not intended for anything hot, so this is just a cute little round to-go container, and it does come in the orange color as well as in yellow. This is awesome. This brush washer, this is perfect for makeup wipes. This is so cool too, because it would suction to the inside of your sink. Fun fact, I use a plastic cutting board to wash my makeup brushes, but this would work even better. This is $3. This is a really, really cool find and item in the dollar spot. It comes in white as well as in this like reddish color. If I was you, I'd buy the reddish color because the white one's definitely gonna stain the first time you use it. Another awesome item is this body brush. It's like a really, really soft exfoliating brush and you can put your hand right through it. This comes in blue as well as yellow, and I have one of these for my face. This is what I use to wash my face. I just love the light exfoliating aspect. It feels really nice and it really does feel like it's getting you clean. So in last week's Target video, I showed you the dustpan. Well, here is the little broom that goes with it. This is a really, really nice dustpan and broom set. I love how it is angled, so it'd be really easy to sweep in the little bits into the dustpan. And I just think it's really pretty. It is $3. Something you can never have too much of are these power strips. Seriously, you can never have too many of these. We are always looking around the house for an extra one of these, and this is $5. Okay, this is so cool. Reusable bottle scrubber. So basically you put it inside and you just shake it and it cleans the inside. And this is only $1. Like I said in the intro, you guys voted and a lot of you wanted to see the back to school stuff. So we're gonna talk about that right now. And for those of you who don't wanna see that, just stick around. I promise there's more after the back to school stuff. So right here in the front, they do have a couple different collection. It seems like they have one that's more like monochromatic. They have really cheap decorative pillows. They have this one that says shine on and just this gray velvety one. And both of these are $5. They also have these storage cubes. I feel like anything with storage and storage optimization just screams college dorm back to school. More $5 pillows. There's this one that says the future is bright. Also this orangey one, this pink velvety one, and then this striped. They also have this corduroy pouf, which is interesting to me. I feel like dorms are way more stylish than they were when I was in college. So maybe that's like for that crowd. They have this big two-person chair that is $80. And they just have a variety of those like classic circle chairs, just like comfy, easily foldable chairs for like $25 and $35. Behind me says like style and snooze, and it kind of has everything broken up by like color. So it's gonna be like more monochromatic, blues, cool tones over here, and then like pinks, warms, and whites. There's just different styles of pillows, throw blankets, some pillows are decorative, and then lamps. What's cool about these lamps though is that they have a bunch of storage in there, so they could keep like a notebook, their phone charger, their phone charging, things like that, their iPad, whatever book they're reading, right on their little nightside lamp. I don't know of any dorm that could fit a futon, but they also have a couple futons over here in this back to school section. For college over in the bathroom section, they're keeping with the same color schemes. You can just find some really cheap like towel sets, perfect for your child to bring to college. Also some bathroom caddies, but in my opinion the ones from the dollar spot right now are actually a lot better, so I would check out those ones first. There are also some flip-flops. These are quite interesting. They have holes in them. Never seen that before. And then just some cheap bath mat sets as well. My favorite back to college item that they bring out every year are these towel wraps. This is the cheapest you can get them all year. They are only $10 a piece and they always come out with really, really awesome patterns. I love these towel dresses. They also have like matching hair wraps and these new microfiber towel twisters. Never seen those before, but these are my favorite items that they bring out every year. Look at these prices though. They have 8-piece wash packs for $5 and 4-piece bath bundles for $10. So definitely really good deals, you can't beat. Here are some more of the bath items. This shower caddy is awesome. These are also great for like cleaning products for anyone, not just someone who's going back to school. They have these shower caddies as well that come with little storage containers. You can put like your soap, your razor, your toothbrush, anything that you just wanna keep like super protected. So they have those as well. And then they have like huge shower caddies. A lot of this stuff is just multi-use. Like this is perfect for anyone for like cleaning products, but also great for back to school. They have shower curtains, they have bathroom sets. These are great. You get the trash can, the soap dispenser, and then a little toothbrush holder. So if they have their own bathroom, you can get this stuff at Target for a really good price. And they have all stuff that just matches and goes together super well. They do of course have comforters and bedding that go along with the same color schemes we have already seen. And right now they are on sale. Here are a few more options of those. They have the little like peach one, black ones, monochromatic. This one's really cool with just like simple line pattern, and these ones are on sale as well. They really have everything matching, like all the same color schemes. So they have like laundry baskets, they have the color coordinated kitchen items, resealable bags, little like to-go food containers, and then lots of matching cups, bowls, plates, all plastic. super easy to like keep clean and super good price. Dish towels, as well as these really cool like soup mugs. I really like these, but I don't actually know if these could go. It says they're in the microwave, but reheat only, that they're microwave safe. Other little bowls, bigger mixing bowls. Tons of stuff. Okay, so that was a lot of the college stuff. Now we're gonna head to the back of the store and check out the back to school stuff, like supplies and things like that. All right, we made it over to the school shop. It's going to have pretty much every item you could expect from a school shop, so I'm not gonna go into great detail about like Crayola markers or glue sticks. I don't really think any of you wanna see that. But of course, they do have those items over in the school shop. I wanna show you items like this: drawing pads, sketch pads, hand lettering kits, and items that they get specifically for this time of the year. They have a bunch of adorable pencil cases, all different styles as well. Oh my gosh. This one's so funny. This one is so funny. It's like made out of silicone, which I didn't know before I picked it up, but this is adorable. It's just a little pencil or like pen holder. That's so funny. They also have character pencil holders. I'm seeing a lot of like Marvel characters, so like the Hulk, Captain America, the Black Panther. So a bunch of little Marvel characters right there. If your child loves Marvel, they have tons of Marvel branded stuff. Like look at this journal. It has like water. I feel like that's a recipe for disaster. I could just see a kid poking this with like a pen or scissors and it just being a complete disaster in the middle of class. They have moved all of the planners over here. So if you or your child are someone that needs to like see things written out, like the dates, so that you know when to anticipate them, that's how I was when I was in school. On the first day, I would get one of these planners and I would write in all the assignment due dates and then I would get them done as fast as I possibly could. But they have moved all those journals and planners over into the back to school section. This one is so pretty. It is by Opal House. It just has this like foiling on it. This one is really, really pretty as well. And it's actually a three section notebook with like gold edges. Those are gorgeous. You already know, this one just caught my eye. Pineapples. They have some new Space Jam stuff. I feel like I saw in the comments that one of your granddaughters loves JoJo Siwa. They also have like mermaids, other fun prints, watercolor, tie-dye, florals, as well as all the basic colors. They have composition notebooks. They do have all the basic normal notebooks. They also have the college ruled ones. The first thing I've seen with Disney princesses on it. They have that down there, another pencil box, tons of like pencil holder options. I don't know if they do this at all Targets. I'm pretty sure they do, but they have all the back to school lists and it says everything that you will need for that grade and that class. They have a baby Yoda wide rule notebook. They have Anna and Elsa, cats, space rabbits, bunch of different designs. I really love this mermaid one. I love how they're all outlined in gold. So pretty. They also have a bunch of insane items for the inside of your locker. Like, look at this. Magnetic urban garden accessory kit. You get this little holder, you get a little magnetic succulent, a mirror. What? You also get a little whiteboard and a marker. This one kills me. This little woven one. Oh my gosh, that is adorable. But they have a ton of different themes for that kind of stuff. They also have this little like photo grid. All these little organizers that are magnetic for the inside of your locker. Like, did you know you needed a magnetic LED tassel light or a disco ball for your locker now, or you're a loser? Yeah, me either. Is this a joke? What? This magnetic letter board is so fun. Honestly, this stuff's kind of fun for like an adult refrigerator as well. Honestly, I'm pretty tempted to pick up this one for our refrigerator. I actually might do that. Any of this stuff could work for anything that's magnetized. I know that they put it over here because it's for a locker, but this would also work for your fridge at home. They have a few locker shelves that help with organization inside of a locker. They also have some string lights. I want to cuss so bad right now. A white fur rug. Okay. They have magnets, succulent magnets, and if you can believe it, a hanging plant magnet. There is a lot of really cute new clothing items over in the clothes section and all the different brands. Definitely gonna have to try some stuff on. Let me show you what I think is super cute, and I'm probably gonna end up trying some stuff on. Hopefully I don't like anything enough to buy it. These new tops have been very, very popular. I'm actually really excited that I found them in the store. It is by the Wild Fable brand. It's just this really nice like satin material, and it comes in this really pretty brown color, this pink color, and then it also comes in black. It might even come in more colors online, but I really, really like it. It's definitely a bit risque, so not for everybody, but I really like it. I'm probably gonna end up trying this on. I'm in love with this dress, specifically in this color. I really, really like it. It just has this pretty eyelet detailing. It's also a high neck. I like that it comes to this V and then has tiers of it. I love this. I love this color as well. I like all of the colors. I really want to try this on too. With a denim jacket, this dress would be chef's kiss. Another dress that I really love is by the A New Day brand. It is this like stripy dress. It cinches in at the waist with a tie, but it's very flowy and it has these really pretty billowy sleeves. I love it in this color right here. Just think it'd be really, really pretty on. It's kind of like seersucker-ish, but it's just all one color. I just think this will be really, really pretty. So I'm definitely gonna try this on too. All right, let's try some of these cuties on. Okay, so here is the green one. I am in love. I think it just gives like such a nice shape. I do actually think I need to size down to a small though, because this is like tied really, really tight. I do find that the A New Day stuff can run a little bit big, and the other brands like Wild Fable can run a little bit small, and then Universal Threads I feel like is really true to size, so just keep that in mind. But yeah, this is the A New Day size medium, but I think I need to size down. But it's so amazing, and it, oh, I just found someone's hair tie in the pocket. But this is really, really adorable. It's also very light, like the material of it. This is a winner. Okay, here is another. This one is by Knox Rose. Not my favorite brand at Target. I also really just like don't like this dress. It's a really easy like throw on and go dress, but one, I don't need any more pink dresses, and two, I just like don't like the material. So I'm not gonna get this. Plus you can see like everything. I don't know, it's just a little bit weird. So I'm not gonna get this one. Okay, here's the next one. I have to be really careful because there's like a really, really big slit on the side. So originally I thought that this was a dress. It's one size fits all, and I'm like, oh my gosh, that's so cute. But actually I think it's like a bathing suit cover up, which is also really adorable. I really, really need a new bathing suit cover up, and it just has like these like little stripes, but I don't know. I just have to be really, really careful in this one, because I'm not trying to get this video like taken down or anything. But yeah, this one's adorable, and I love like the taupe and cream stripe. Really, really nice bathing suit cover up. Just as I suspected, I love this one. I just really like how high it comes up and how it comes to like a little V. Really, really cute with a denim jacket. This is a little bit too big. I grabbed a large because, like I said, the Wild Fable brand, it always runs really small, but I'm gonna size down to a medium. But I really like it. It's really, really pretty for the fall. You can wear it with or without a denim jacket. I just always feel more comfortable in a denim jacket. Working on that, the confidence I have in my arms. I hate my arms. I think I've talked about that on here. But yeah, this is just a really cute outfit. This is definitely like a classic Katie outfit. That's how I would categorize it. So probably gonna pick up this as well. Just to tell you about pricing, this yellow dress is $25. This cover-up is $28. The Knox Rose dress is also $28, and then the A New Day dress is also $28. So these three are $28, and this one is $25. Also just wanted to show you what I'm wearing today. I'm wearing one of these Old Navy swing dresses. I think I've talked about these before. I have them in like a million colors and patterns. They're just the easiest dress to throw on and go. I will link it down below for you guys. I seriously have them in so many colors and patterns. They're just a great bathing suit cover up, really great easy dress. And then just denim jacket and these Target sandals that I've been living in. If you see me in another outfit somewhere in this video, no you didn't. Pretend you didn't. I ruined the illusion later in this video, but we're gonna pretend that it was all filmed with this outfit. They have moved the entire Opal House summer collection to clearance. There's these glasses, all these like little containers. They even have a little pineapple one, bunch of napkins. And all of this stuff is on clearance. All the plates, bowls from this collection, tablecloths, it is all gone to clearance. One item I found that is kind of funny is this Easter item. There's nothing wrong with it. So we're gonna scan it and see how much it is. I feel like this definitely shouldn't be here, so it's probably gonna come up as zero. All right, we're gonna give this a scan. Just as I suspected, $0. Doesn't mean it's actually $0. I have to go up to guest services and see how much they would give this to me for. 4th of July pillows are officially on clearance as well. Right now they are 30% off. They are trying to figure out the price of the item, but it was supposed to be sent to salvage. So basically they just have to put a price on it. And I'm hoping I can buy it for like $1, but there's also a chance they might not sell it to me. They hooked it up, got it for $1. She hooked it up for $1? I'm pumped. Only at Target, you can only get this customer service at Target. The amazing employee, Regina, she hooked it up. They were trying to figure it out for like a few minutes, but it's always the same story when I find random items like that. She came over and she's like, you've been so patient, like how much do you want to pay for it? I was like, I don't know, like $2. I'm like, I'm willing to pay $2, would be even happier to pay $1. She's like, I got you. I got it for $1, so thanks, Regina. Alrighty, you guys, that is gonna be it for me today. I really hope that you enjoyed this week's Target Tuesday. If you did, please make sure to go ahead and give it a big thumbs up and make sure you are subscribed down below. I'm putting out 4 videos a week. Big things are coming. Christmas decor, fall decor. Well, fall decor and then Christmas decor. Clearly, you can see where my loyalty lies. But I'm so excited for all of it, and I know that you guys aren't gonna wanna miss it, so make sure you are subscribed by hitting the subscribe button down below. This week's questions with Katie, Katie's quick question, I still don't know what I'm gonna call it, but I promise I'm gonna figure it out really soon. It's coming from a YouTube comment. It is from Paula. She said, I know you worked at Disney World. What did you do there? You might have talked about this in a previous video, but I'm a relatively new subscriber. So hey Paula, thank you so much for submitting that question. So for those of you who don't know, I worked at Disney from 2014. That's when I did the Disney College program until right up until the pandemic. I did go home and finish college. So technically I took a break from like 2015 to 2016, but I worked at Disney starting in 2014 and I stopped working there technically in 2020, but I was a cast member up until a couple months ago. I've done several things with Disney on the Disney College program. I started out as a seater. I've always worked in restaurants pretty much my whole life up until now. So I started out as a seater on the Disney College program. So I was just a hostess. Then I went home, finished school. I got my bachelor's in hospitality management. I always knew I wanted to work at Disney. That's always been my plan. If it was my choice, I probably wouldn't have even gone home to finish school because I did not want to leave Disney at all. But in the end, I'm glad I got my degree. I went back to Disney as a server. So I was a server for about a year. After that, I became a manager and I ended up being a food and beverage manager in the Germany Pavilion in Epcot. Then I was in Disney Springs. I opened a few restaurants in Disney Springs. Then I got sent back to Epcot and I was doing the festivals, so like Food and Wine, Flower and Garden Festival, and then I went back to being a server. My goal was to get my master's degree because if you didn't know, Disney has the Aspire program, so they'll pay for you to get your degree. But at the time, it wasn't for salaried positions like I was as a manager. It was only for hourly positions. So I went back to being a server so that I could pursue my master's degree. I had just gotten accepted for the University of Central Florida hospitality master's degree. I was really excited. And right when that happened, the pandemic hit. Honestly, everything happens for a reason. I was not happy that the pandemic hit, but I really didn't want to go back to school for my master's degree. It was kind of something that my mom was pushing me to do more than anything. Sorry, mom, if you're watching this. So right now I could still be working at Disney pursuing my master's degree and that would have been great, but I don't think I ever would have met Brian if the whole pandemic didn't happen. Because if you didn't know, I met Brian right in the beginning of the pandemic. So if all that didn't happen, I wouldn't be here right now. I wouldn't be filming this video. So everything definitely happens for a reason. But yes, I did work at Disney for close to 7 years and I loved it. It was amazing. It was an amazing time. I miss it so much. It was so hard for me to say no to going back to Disney because I really am super, super passionate about it. I always knew I wasn't gonna work there forever because my biggest dream in life is to get married and have a family and be a stay-at-home mom. So I always knew that I wasn't gonna work at Disney forever, but I just could never have predicted my time there to be cut so short or it to all happen when it did or how it did. No one could have predicted the way the last like year and a half went, but ultimately I wouldn't change a thing. But yes, I did work at Disney. It was amazing. We still live in Florida and we go to Disney all the time and it's really, really nice to go as a guest. But yeah, so that is the answer to your question. If you guys want to be featured in an upcoming Questions with Katie, maybe that's what I'll call it. That's what we're gonna call it. If you want to be featured in an upcoming Questions with Katie, please leave me a question down below. I may just go ahead and answer your question in a comment if I don't think that I will use it in a future video, but I still want to answer your question. But yes, please leave me a question below to answer in a future segment. But alrighty, you guys, that is gonna be it for me. Thank you so much for watching and I'll see you next time. Bye guys.